What's up, guys? It's been a long time, you know? Jesus, all my favorite guys, like, you know? Jeez, I'm about to cry. I'm
chilling. In your hometown, too.
Oh, yeah, that too.
How you feeling?
Feeling good. I'm just kind of working out every day, trying to stay consistent, working with the training staff, strength staff, making sure I make improvements, keep working through it.
Where are you at in the process? What kind of stuff you doing at this point?
Yeah, I mean, right now it's just progressing. There's certain checkpoints and things like that, but as you can see, able to start walking, things like moving, body weight work in the training room, nothing heavy or anything. So it's been good to finally, mentally for me, to be able to do stuff like that again.
Early in the process, you have a kind of targeted return day when you think you'll be good to go?
No, it's just kind of working out each and every day. Obviously, like any other football player, they want to get back as soon as possible. But for me, it's just making sure I do the right things, listen to the strength staff, listen to the training staff. And when they say it's go time, I know I'll be ready to go.
After a guy that had been so durable throughout his career, when something like this hits, do you kind of take a step back and say, wow, because you begin to think that maybe you'll never be in a situation where you're hurt?
No, yeah, it's definitely a tough moment. But for me, I've always been a person that just loves the challenge. And when this happens, obviously it sucks to happen, but it's something that I could put, I don't know, on my bucket list of something I worked through and came back and conquered.
What have you seen? I mean, you know, you'd rather be in the middle of it calling everything, but what have you seen watching this team for pretty much the whole season?
No, yeah, I think you see improvements each and every week. Obviously, I'm a big defensive guy, so be able to watch that and see how the guys are starting to mesh together, playing really well as of late, and just seeing the guys grow, especially at the inside linebacker position.
What was your reaction when you heard you guys were going to become the Tucson for the week?
No, I was excited for it. I mean, I have my bittersweet moments here. They didn't want me to play here, so went to Stanford and became smart. but no, it's good. I've been kind of the tour guide, showing people around, showing the good spots to eat and things like that.
What sort of places have you taken them to eat?
So my favorite Mexican food spot was Guadalajara Grill. So we went there, great spot. They cooked the salsa in front of you and things like that. And then we did a team activity at my dad's cousin's place, no anchovies, great pizza. And then we went to, I think, Fleming's, which, I mean, Fleming's everywhere, but yeah.
I think it was a youngster that got to go out during stretch with Saquon. What do you think that meant to a local kid to, one, see an NFL team come in here, but have a chance to go out on a field like that with an NFL player?
No, I think it's huge. I think, I mean, I look back to the days where if one person, didn't even matter if it was practice squad, whatever, first round draft pick, whatever it was, if someone came up to me and spent their time to say hi to me, to talk to me, it was one of those moments that I look back and I'm like, I want to become that person. I get that motivation. I get that drive to be able to be that next guy that's all of a sudden talking to a kid, and I'm not the kid anymore.
Blake, because you guys are here and not in New Jersey during a regular practice week, I know most of your day is probably rehab.
Yep.
Early in the morning. Are you getting to spend more time with the guys, whether it's in meetings or
yeah,
you know, just that night, just because you're?
No, yeah, 100%. And I think it's slowly grown more and more over the past couple weeks where I've been able to be kind of incorporated with the group, whether it's lifting, meetings, and all these types of things. And obviously, like here, I'm the tour guide going to dinners and stuff like that. So it's been fun.
Have you been able to, like, you're a leader of this team, to not be on the field, like, how can you still lead? Can you find opportunities to lead? Do you, behind the scenes, that, like, we don't see?
No, yeah. I mean, especially for the inside linebacker group, Tay, in general, being able to talk to him, whether he comes in the training room while I'm rehabbing or in the locker room. I'll be in meetings every now and then, depending on my rehab schedule, and be able to talk to guys. And I watch the games, every game. And so talking through to him on what he can kind of change up, what he can see, how he can hit things quicker and those type of things.
Where are you during the home games? Where are you?
So this last game against Miami was the first time I was able to go on the field and things like that because of my knee. But typically I'm just watching at home.
How many guys have come to see the facility and what has been their impression?
The facility here? So actually we're going today. Potentially, I don't know how many people. I invited everybody. So we'll see if it can fit that many people. I think it can. But we'll see what they think after that.